stars Ashleigh Murray and Vanessa Morgan. Hello, hello, welcome. Welcome to the Scream Queens panel. Hi, ladies.
Hi.
We're starting to roll through with these working mics. That's what we decided backstage. Yes. So Ashleigh, you take it off now. Okay, go for it.
Get it, girl.
Okay, so if you're here, you know what this is. We got some diehard fans here. I don't know if any of you guys saw this on Twitter, but I asked you guys a specific question and y'all came through. So hopefully we, yes you did. So hopefully we can ask as many fan-centric questions as possible. I think you're gonna be very happy though. But also we just wanna have some fun girl chat, right?
Girl chat.
Right? Okay, so I kind of wanna talk about getting started in the business because we all know your stories, but people don't realize how hard it is to actually be cast on a television show. It is a process. It's kind of like winning the lottery or being struck by lightning because you have to go through all these auditions, then you have to book the pilot, and then you have to make it through the pilot, and then you have to make sure that your show is actually successful. Yeah. So what have you guys done, because you're all on successful shows, what have you guys done to kind of keep yourselves grounded in this process?
I think, I'll start. The biggest thing that I've had to do is a lot of self-care and a lot of self-love. There's just so much that goes into making a show. Regardless of where you are on the cast list, the days are long, it's strenuous work, you know, and then on top of that, like, you know, we live so far from set and we shoot in another country and like I'm based here, so traveling back and forth it's a lot and it takes a toll on you. And the best thing that I could do was just to make sure I was getting enough sleep, make sure that I was eating well, make sure that I was staying in contact with people who are my support system whenever I'm feeling very down. Because this past year for me, I was fully depressed for 9 months. You know, I found out I'm a seasonal depressant and it is super rainy in Vancouver all the time. And it got to a point where I just felt like I was trapped in this dark hole. And the only thing that I could do was pull away from that and make sure that I was giving myself back the energy that I found myself losing.
Did you buy a happy light?
Oh, thank you for calling it a happy light. Yes, I did. I bought a happy light and some liquid vitamin D drops. Yes. In case you're wondering, if you're deficient in vitamin D, it's better to take it in a liquid form as opposed to a pill form. Your body absorbs it better. Note from my naturopath.
Yes, Dr.
Thank you, Canada.
I love it. Katie, do you have anything to offer?
Well, just that I broke my mic, so...
It's like a tiny little baby mic.
It's a microphone. I'm just going to hold it like this.
She's physically grounded to the couch at this point.
I'll just get that awkwardness out of the way. I think the biggest thing that I've learned as an actor in terms of... I know, because a lot of people are interested in acting and want to do it. And the biggest thing that I think I've learned, like, going through the audition process, all this, is, like, nobody wants to see you give what they want. Like, you have to learn to, like, find yourself and who you are, and then you give what you want to give, and then it's whether or not they want it. And you got to separate that from, like, personal rejection, because you get a lot of rejection.
I'm sure. So then, what keeps you guys motivated? You guys are all on a successful television program, so what keeps you motivated to keep going?
Money, honey.
Run that check. Run me that check, y'all.
I love you. What keeps me motivated? I try to never lose sight of, you know, 5-6 years ago, all I wanted was to be a lead female on a television show. And I would have given anything to be here. And now it's my day in, my day out. It's become normal for me, but I try and have moments of really being grateful, as hard as it is. You know, you get into a routine, but I try to remind myself that I am very lucky. I'm one of the chosen few that gets to be on a successful TV show. And so, I don't know, gratitude is a huge thing for me, I think. You know, that is what true happiness is being grateful for exactly where you are and what you have.
That's Exactly. Vanessa, joining the cast the second season, what was that like for you?
I mean, I mean it was obviously super, super nerve-wracking for me, you know, because they already created their own little family, so joining season two, I was nervous and people like me. But one of my best friends, I told you before, was already on the show, Madeline. So she kind of like brought me to set, showed me around. She's like, this is my best friend, guys.
You're welcome.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, she did. What? I love you too. So I instantly kind of felt at home, and then and I love my servants, my servant guys. So yeah, I mean, I just feel like a family, and I'm so happy Mystery's regular now.
So one of the fan questions was, you know, Tony and Cheryl, or Choney, if you will. Am I saying that? Choney. They have officially solidified their relationship.
Yeah.
Okay. So what's it like working with Madeline on that?
I mean, it's great. I mean, I remember having lunch with her in LA and us being like, she was on Riverdale and I wasn't. And I finished filming this other show I was on called Shannara Chronicles. And I was like, one day I'm gonna book a show that films in Vancouver so we can be together and do our routine and stuff like that. And then I ended up getting on Riverdale, and then we ended up dating. So I was like, I kind of won the lottery. Not only am I gonna be on the same show as my best friend, but now we get to be girlfriends. You know what I mean? Yeah. And hey, like, instead of kissing one of like the actors on the show, you might as well be your best friend.
Yeah.
Our first kiss, we were like, how are we doing this? Okay, we're gonna grab you, we're gonna touch you. Like, we were like, it was like super comfortable. You know?
Exactly. So, you were safe with her.
Same. So I really lucked out.
Okay, so you're all screen queens, but I want to know what you're obsessing over. What shows are you guys obsessing over?
I'm obsessed with Schitt's Creek. I've been talking about it for months. I love that show.
They deserve all the credit, right? They deserve all the credit. They're amazing.
It's a really awesome show. I love the fact that it's like a company that is Dan Levy and Eugene Levy, and their daughter plays the, she plays the waitress. Like, it's a whole, it's just, and Catherine O'Hara, like, it's just a great show. I'm obsessed with that show.
Candice, I watch so much television. It's literally the only thing I do. And then when I get this question, I'm like, what's television?
What is that show you wanted me to watch?
That wasn't a very good show. Oh, no, Marvelous Mrs. Maisel on Amazon. Yeah. Bomb.com. If you want to see a really powerful, strong female lead, great, great show. Thank you, Caity.
Of course. So all of your characters have source material, right? So it's kind of like a big step to step into their shoes. What was the hardest thing about becoming these characters and living up to that material?
For me, Iris West was traditionally white in the comic books. So, you know, comic book fans are very opinionated. Very vocal. So it was very scary stepping into that role when I started the show. And I remember our executive producer at this time, once I got cast, he was like, don't go online, just don't go on. But what's great is I think over time people have embraced me and embraced this character, and I think it's really important. So thank you. And I think what's great is, you know, years to come, people will remember Iris West as being African American, and that's a really, really cool thing.
Ashleigh, I see you shaking your head.
It's the exact same thing.
Yeah.
You know, Josie, she's originally white in the comics, and so is Melody, and, you know, we all ended up coming as an all-black group. And when I actually was testing for it, my aunt asked me, you know, how are you going to deal with it if you book this? How are you going to handle people having an issue with it? And I was like, well, we'll just worry about it when it comes. And then when it came, I did exactly that. They were like, just don't even go on the internet. Don't check social media. And I've seen people say some really unfortunate things, but there was so much happiness and gratitude and support outside of that negativity that it kind of outweighed it, and now it's not, it's just white noise. Like, I don't even notice it or see it much anymore. And it's probably thanks to you, because if you had to go through it before I did, you probably made the transition a little bit easier.
And I think that's the thing, the more we do it, the more we get cast, the more we unfortunately take the brunt.
Right.
The easier it's gonna get on every woman of color that comes after us that's cast on these shows. It's gonna become the normal, I hope, sooner than later. But, you know, if I had to deal with, you know, crap online and harassment online so you know, a girl that looks like me 10 years from now can successfully be on these shows without any of that, then well worth it, I can take it.
Have there been any particular scenes that you guys were nervous to film?
Anytime
there's any kind of like sex scene, it's always kind of nerve-wracking.
I imagine.
I think when you have to be in like lingerie or anything like that. There was when I first got cast on Arrow, which your Arrow fans, you probably already know that there was another Sarah Lance in the very first pilot episode, and then when we reshot that. Me getting sucked out of the gambit. I had to be in like lingerie, and it was literally the same lingerie that the other girl wore. And they're like, here, like, it has to be this. And I'm like, it doesn't fit me. My boobs are too small. And they're like, just fill it. Like, it has to be the same one. But
oh my goodness.
And they always shut down sets anytime there's like a sex scene, or like when Kyler Lay and I were like, we had our one night stand. So, like, we were like, you know, naked in bed, and they clear out the entire set, and everyone like makes a huge deal out of it, right?
Yeah.
Like they're like, are you comfortable? Like we'll clear everybody out. Like if there's ever anything that feels uncomfortable, just yell stop, and we'll stop. And I'm like, can you just calm down? Like everyone just take a break. Like just be normal. That's always nerve-wracking.
Anyone else?
Got it. But, like on Riverdale?
Yeah.
I think the most nervous I was for a scene was probably when I had to kiss Jughead, only because of the fact that I knew how much the fans wouldn't like that. You know what I mean? Like I'm interfering in another relationship.
I was live tweeting that night. I saw the Twitter.
Yeah.
It was ablaze. It was like that meme. Everything is fine. This is fine. And like everything's on fire.
And then,
This is going well. But you came out of that storyline for the better.
Yeah,
right?
For the better, 100%.
Exactly. Okay, I want to get into some storyline topics, if you guys don't mind. Yes, okay, so I actually want to start with Ashleigh first, though. So, are we going to see Josie and the Pussycats reunite in season 3? Can we see more of them? What's happening?
I don't know. I don't have an answer for that. I imagine that they're gonna come back, but I'm not sure how and in what way. Like, I don't know.
Is there anybody on the show that you guys wish you worked with more?
Everybody? Everyone? Anyone?
Vanessa. Hart Denton, he plays Chick. I know his character is like bad. But I just love him as a person, so more scenes of him.
Ashleigh, what would you like to see happen with Josie in season 3? How would you like to see her develop more?
I would love to see Josie really battle with the undoing of her household. You know, she's not 3 years old, so she's going to remember the fact that her parents are getting divorced. And the weight of a divorce, especially if the home is relatively happy or you have really close relationships with your parents, oftentimes undoes you. And so she's going through puberty and seeing how the divorce is happening and her dad's not around. I think that we could really lean into that and see what that turns her into, because she's always supposed to be a good girl. She listens to her mom and she never makes waves. And I feel like this could create a wedge that would be really enjoyable to watch. I also would love to see her really find what her sound is, you know, and it could be great to see that happen through this pain. Unfortunately, some really great things come from dark, hurt places, and oftentimes it ends up healing you in the process. So I would love to see something like that go on with Josie.
Me too. Caity, so Sarah became the de facto leader of Legends last season. So why is that important?
I can't get over this. I think just at first it's like, I remember everyone being like, wow, like she's a woman and she's the leader of the group. Like it's this big deal. And I'm like, yeah, like of course she's the leader.
Duh.
But I think another big deal about it is like, she's a bisexual woman. Like, and if you think about like, specifically bisexual representation on television and how much it's lacking, and to see a female bisexual character as the like lead, the captain of the ship, is I think a really, really nice step in progress for representation.
Exactly. You can speak to that, Vanessa, about yeah. Tony, because yeah. I know the fans were really excited when, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. I know that everybody was so excited to see Toni Topaz come onto the show, knowing that she is a bisexual character. So what did that mean for you personally? I know we've talked about it a little bit.
Yeah. I mean, personally, as you said, I don't think it's represented as much as it should be in the media. So I love being able to represent that love is love. I mean, I personally believe that. I feel like you can fall in love with a person's soul regardless of their gender. So I love representing that. I love people coming up to me and saying, oh, because of them, I was able to come out to my family. And because I didn't have that growing up. I didn't have somebody that, you know, that I could relate to being biracial
yes.
growing up on TV. So I love that people can now see that and have somebody that, you know, that's like me.
Yeah, exactly. Candice, why was it important for Iris to rededicate herself to investigative journalism this year?
I mean, Iris West, reporter, like if you've read the comics, that's like bread and butter. So I think story-wise, we've been separated from that for so long. I think fans, you know, and rightfully so, were a little irritated by that. I think it's also important to see women doing what they love instead of just being seen as, you know, a romantic love interest on the show. It's always been really important to me that Iris has agency and that we see her at work contributing. I always say, women, these characters, us as women, we are so much more than the man or the woman that we are, you know, in a relationship with. And so I really wanted that for Iris, and I hope we do it justice next season. I'm a little, you know, worried how we fit that into the world that we've created with Star Labs, but yeah, if they can do it right, I think it could be great. I would love to see Iris being a dope reporter, but she's in the comics.
Fans want to see a scene between you and Caity Cassidy soon. Do you think that's a possibility?
I have no idea. Isn't she evil now? Is she evil?
The Black Siren now.
Okay.
The Laurel Lance is just a joke. But Black Siren is alive.
I mean, anything is possible, especially with these crossovers that we do every single year. There's so many actors from this universe that I haven't worked with.
Yeah.
And Caity is up there. I would love to work with her.
Do you guys get confused with the crossovers because there's so many people and so many more important parts involved?
Feuds?
Confused.
So confused.
It is confusing. Like, story-wise, half the time we're shooting, I have no idea what's going on, where it is in the story. Like, I constantly need someone to be like, what just happened? Where were we? And it's just, it's a lot. I really hope you guys enjoy those crossovers because they damn near kill us every single year.
Yeah, we shoot all of them at the same time. It's not like you shoot Flashes and then Arrows and then Legends and then Supergirls. They're all happening within the same 2 weeks. We shoot a 2-hour movie in 10 days.
Yeah, so you start, you wake up and you're on Flash for a couple hours and then they're like, okay, you gotta go over to Legends. Legends needs you. And then Legends is backed up, so you're waiting, and it's absolute insanity for the cast, the crew, everyone. I don't know how.
But it's fun.
It's
fun. We enjoy it. Like,
it is fun, actually.
We get, like, sometimes we can carpool to work together.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm on the Flash today.
Like, yeah, like, when Caity was on Flash working, we stayed in the same trailer with our dogs and, like, just hung out.
Okay. Well, you guys have dogs on set?
Don't jinx it.
That's my dog, my Yoshi. Yoshi sits. Yoshi has his own little like cast here. Well, they're making one for next season.
Wait, are they?
Wait, what?
Can you bring your dog?
He sits on set with me during the scene. He's so quiet. He just sits there.
My dog is not.
She would be.
Yeah,
really, really cute.
Barking up.
So, Caity, how do you think your character was impacted by the death of her father on Arrow?
I know, right? It's like everything. It's so sad. Like, why does everything that love die?
That was the question. It's like, you're losing everything. How does she cope?
Right? I'm hoping, I think they're starting to try to steer away from one show affecting the other show so too much because it gets really complicated, but I don't know where they're going to go with it, but I really hope that we get to deal with it more. I mean, I'd love to, like, go back onto Arrow and like have some vengeance kick ass happening.
I agree. And for Iris, how do you think that she reacted to knowing that she has a daughter now?
I mean, I think anyone in that position would be like, what the, you know? Because it's weird, her daughter came back from the future essentially at the same age that she is currently. So it's super trippy. I think both her and Barry are kind of like, what the hell?
Yeah.
And that also means that, you know, Iris has to be pregnant at some point. When does that happen? How does this affect the time continuum if she's coming back from the past? Like, could it fuck up? I said fudge. Could it, like, fudge up, you know, storylines? Could Barry and I not be together? I have no idea, like, what could happen.
Okay, so speaking of crossovers, I want to ask you guys about Sabrina. Would your hopes be that there is a crossover at some point with y'all's series, or do you have any thoughts on this at all?
I'm gonna say no, and I say no because Sabrina is a very different world, and I don't know how and if they're going to play into her magicalness, and it's not just her that has that situation, and Riverdale is so based in this type of reality that I'm not sure that bringing the two together, if it's something that you could just walk away from, if it would just be one off thing and then like it's fun and, you know, to be able to separate the two, I think it would be a lot. I mean, our show is already so large, and I think bringing that in, it would just make it, it would just kind of be like, you know, you mix a bunch of paint together and you just get a bunch of brown. Not, there's anything wrong with brown.
I will say that I would love it though. I would love it. It does take place in Greendale or Riverdale, you know, where, what's the substitute teacher's name?
Which substitute?
The one that got killed?
Grundy. Right, yeah.
Like, she's from Greendale. I personally, because I was obsessed with Sabrina growing up, I love magic, I love all that stuff. I would love it if we went over.
Let's see what happens.
They shoot in Vancouver too, right? They shoot it in Vancouver.
They shoot like across the street.
Wow.
Do you guys used to watch the GIF, like the Sabrina?
I think they're too bad.
But you guys know? No? No, TJ? Sabrina, Teenage Witch.
Yeah.
Oh. TJF Fridays.
Yes.
Like my TV night.
That was like dinosaurs.
Yes. I was like, you guys gotta be too young for that, right?
No.
Yes. Okay, I want to talk about She Gordy. If you notice, we're all wearing these pants.
Yes, queen.
Okay, so what plans do you and the other DC women have for it? And can we expect a website soon? What is going on with She Gordy? You're probably wearing these pins.
Well, the great thing about it is we're really expanding also just beyond like our DC TV shows. We've been talking to our Riverdale girls over here. And we are going to be launching a website soon. Hopefully, I think we should see something in the next month. And the cool thing about the website, for us, this whole thing is about community. It's about empowerment. And like, it's not like us and ours and a platform for us to speak to you. It's like a platform for us all to speak together.
Yes.
And so the main format of this website is article-based, and we would love for each of you guys to write an article, and you just submit it, and you'll be able to submit it on the website, and then we're going to put all the articles on the website, and we're going to be writing articles, and there's going to be videos. It's basically, you can talk about whatever it is you want, and it's, you know, all things feminine, female, but going beyond that scope, anyone who identifies as female, and basically even men, like, we all have a feminine side to us, we all have a mom, you know, like, it applies to everybody, but it's all about getting us to lift each other up, like, getting rid of the, like, competition, no more needing to, like, tear each other down, it's learn from each other's mistakes, like, share something, and the whole thing is, talk about something that you've overcome, you've dealt with, like how you dealt with bullying, how you overcame an eating disorder or depression, and then sharing that with everyone. So I also just want to say, like, I feel like as women, our culture has set it up so that we look at each other as competition, as enemies, as whatever. That's something that I grew up with. I'm sure it's still happening in your generation, and that's something I really hope we help to break down with She Gordy. I think when you sit down with other women, you
share your story, you understand that we have so much more in common than we have that's not in common. So we really, really want you guys to connect with each other, share your stories, and have a support system.
Yeah, like, we're going to do an article together, and we're just going to basically interview each other, and so we'll post that on there, and really, really do, like, we need you guys to make it happen, so.
Well, thank you guys for doing that, and I think that you give back so much to the fans by doing that, and women in general, so thank you so much. I want to get to some fun questions. I'm looking at the timer, I'm like, oh my god, our time is almost up. So, let's get into some fun stuff. What is, and not like the other stuff wasn't fun, am I right? Okay. So, what is your favorite product to carry in every single one of your bags? You have it at all times.
Hand lotion. I, like, you wash your hands all the time, and I hate the feeling of dry hands, so I always have hand lotion. Like, I'm not trying to walk around looking like I'm playing in powder, okay? Like, I gotta stay moist.
Yeah, maybe, like, this lavender hand sanitizer spray I have from Whole Foods. Or Neosporin.
I love it.
It's Eco?
It's called Eco?
No, it's not Eco.
Oh.
It's a different one.
Oh.
And then, the Neosporin for some reason. I put that, I use it all the time.
It's great on your lips.
For what?
Is it actually?
Yes.
Oh.
Wow.
Yeah.
It doesn't dry you out?
No.
That's
great.
Wow. Fun facts. For me, sunscreen. Wear your sunscreen, ladies. I know I sound like a mom, but like, wear your sunscreen.
You know how I feel about sunscreen. Mine is I have like this facial spray. It's like a rose water glycerin facial spray
from Mario Badescu.
Is it? Yeah. I don't know where it is, but the grocery store, you can make your own.
It's a really good one.
And I, all the time, it's like, you just have a little mini shower.
Just a little spritzy. Okay, what has been your biggest, we have some fan, boys, girls, people here, okay? What's been your biggest fangirl moment? Caity has something.
Well, just recently, I was in London, and I met Dr. Strange. And I was with Natalia Ritchie, she's on Destiny Survivor, and she's married to Robbie now. We were at some, like, posh London club, and she's gonna hate that I'm telling this story. She geeked out. And she was like trying to keep her cool so much. And like, she was like, hey, what's up? You know, I'm gonna drink. Hey, what is it? Do you need a refill? I'm gonna get some more drinks. Like, no, you're good. All right, okay. And then comes back and is like, well, maybe I'll just wait for the bartender. And then like, they leave. And she was like, wow, I like played that so cool. I was like, girl, you just fangirled out so hard. But it was really cute. And he was so nice. He really, like, was the nicest person ever. And I just read something about him jumping out of the cab and, like, fighting off muggers or something.
Oh, I read that. But I didn't know if it was real or not.
So I would believe it.
I don't want to spread that around. Anybody else?
I have nothing.
I have nothing. I've actually ridden the plane with Queen Latifah 3 times now. And just recently it happened again. And I'm too much of a punk to, like, walk up to her and tell her that, like, we fly the same class, girl. But I just can't. I secretly fangirled inside. I just recently met Lucy Liu, and I adore her. And I didn't expect her to be there. I was just going over to Mark's house. He plays Hiram. I was going over to his house for dinner, and I knew that Casey was gonna be there, and like, Kelly was there, and Ryan Seacrest was there, and then Kelly was like, oh, I want you to meet my friend Lucy, and I turn, and it's just this, like, goddess standing in front of me. I was like, we're the same height! And so I just tried to, like, keep it cute the whole night, and then at the end, I started to, like, word vomit about how much I adore her, and I grew up watching her, and she's so great, and you should go blonde, and she went blonde. We were actually talking about, she was asking about dyeing her hair, and Kelly was like, no, don't do it, they're gonna bleach it, it's gonna be awful, and I was like, well, let me give you the tea, okay? All you gotta do is put a little low-level lightener on there, it'll take that color right on out, and then they deposit the yellow in, and boom, you're blonde. And now, I don't know if you've seen Lucy Liu lately, but she's got this beautiful, yummy, honey blonde texture, and I was like, I was there before. And then I go down, I gave you that piece. That's probably about it.
Okay, so the question I want to end on is, what is one goal that you guys have for the next year for yourselves?
For me, it's still self-care. Oh, I'm sorry, were you about to say?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We all just keep looking at each other like,
yeah. It's still the same thing. Like, it took me so long to get to this point, and everything I thought I was prepared for didn't turn out to be that way. It's a lot more stress than I expected, and even my life is in a different place, like my personal life. So for me, just making sure that I'm good, because if I'm not good, I can't do anything else. So that's what I'm trying to do.
I love you. You're the best.
Me too.
You had to make me nuts.
Is that why you're avoiding eye contacts? Like,
yeah, it's your goals. Outside of the Riverdale realm, I would love to set a goal of, you know, doing a really cool independent movie, something super cringy. But yeah, definitely taking care of myself is super important. I suffer from anxiety. It's something that, you know, comes in and out. I would love to, you know, work on that a bit more, especially when you're working long hours. I think the most important thing in life is just to be content, just be super happy. I think my goal would just be 2018, just be like the best version of yourself and just be happy and enjoy the little things. I think that's a good goal as well.
For me, probably, I really want to work on being healthier. That's something that I've struggled with, I think, this past year. Which is fine, we all have our moments. But yeah, I want to make that more of a priority and a goal, just because I feel better. My friend says I have walls, so I should work on breaking those down. I don't know, meet some people, meet a man. I don't know.
Caity. Besides Sheet Authority, which is like a huge focus, I'm gonna shop more.
No, Caity.
Go shopping more?
Yes.
I'm gonna get my closet
on point.
And I'm gonna make Candice shop more.
Oh god.
That's, you guys are both in Vancouver filming, right?
Yeah.
I wanna be invited.
Yes.
We're going shopping after this if you wanna come. Ooh. I need to get a new bag. I wanna get a nice double bag that can bring a set.
Alright, ladies, thank you so much. This was a lot of fun, guys. I hope you had a good time.
Thank you guys.